baby. Cause I will be a freak through the day until the dawn. And I can do whatever thing you like, boy, what you want. Cause we ain't gotta tell nobody. We ain't gotta tell nobody. Cause it goes on. Hola! So, do you guys like this look? Which you guys asked me to do something different, and I listen this time. I usually try to listen, you know, but it just depends on like what I'm feeling, you know? So I'm gonna sit like this because it look a little better from this side. So this wig that I'm wearing is actually from a company called Wig Encounters. And they contacted me, I don't know, it's been probably like in June, I wanna say, and asked me to do a review for them. And you guys know, I don't know if you guys, if I said this already, but for the newer year, I'm gonna switch back into just full lace wigs or lace front wigs because I'm really over kind of the wefted hair. So in the top of the year, like once I'm done with what I got going on as far as reviews are concerned, I'm going back to just regular wigs because I'm just kind of over the wefted hair. Like it's just getting on my nerves. So I'm gonna give you guys the specs of this wig and then I'll tell you how I came about this, and I'm sure you can tell by the title who was inspired by. But yeah, Indian Remy, the hair black, I mean the hair black. The hair color is a 1B, which is an off black. My hair length was originally 12 inches. So before I started to chop and got scissor happy for this wig, it was 12 inches. It's baby hair around the perimeter. So it was a 150 density overall, but I believe that my perimeter was a 130. It was a natural pre-plucked hair line and it was an average size cap. This Wig Encounters is serving people who are new to those who are new to wigs, or those who are beginners and hesitate to install wigs by themselves, worry about not looking good or natural. So here we are. We also bring specific tutorials and best customer service. Okay, so it came with all the standard stuff that you would get with a wig, which is, you know, the lunch lady net. It came in this, it had this in between. It came with, I'm still trying to figure out why they're still shipping these. I've never worn or used one of these because they don't work for me, but okay. So, to my actual hair. So, I want to start off by saying with the cap construction of this wig, there were three combs in this wig. So there were two right here and there's one right here. There's also adjustable strap in the back. Now, what I did was there was a comb that came right here by this part and I took it out because you could see it. And I could have put a little bit of concealer on it, but you guys know I like a very deep side part. And this particular look itself was actually inspired by Teyana Taylor's hair at the VMAs, which I thought was just everything. And I know that Japanese faces did her makeup, so I tried to keep my makeup as demure as possible, hence why I don't have like a lot of line. I have no wing liner. Things look very natural. They're not overdone, which I kind of miss this. When I usually do looks, I do them based on like just a whole glam look, but it does feel good and it's cool to have like a very cool, laid back, cozy vibe. I got this sweater from Forever 21. It's huge on me, as you've probably seen in my intro, which I haven't shot yet. So I looked at her photo, so I'll lean over so you guys can see. I used this photo as an inspiration and they had like different angles of it or whatever. So I changed some things on the wig. For myself, and the reason why I wanted to do this look is because it was something that I had not done before. I haven't really did a cut like this since beauty school, which has been forever. So I really wanted to test my skills on how great I could actually cut this. And I'm very proud of myself. The only thing that I don't like is this part right here. Which if I did some texturing back here, it would lay down a little bit flatter, but every time I move my neck, it'll do that, which I don't like. And that's kind of the thing with short hair that I'm not a big fan of. But again, that was me being lazy because I was shooting this in between some other stuff. She had a lot of baby hair right here. So she had like one right here that went from here to here, and then she had another that went from here to here, and then it was a sideburn. Her sideburn was shorter than this one as well, so I decided to go ahead and keep this long on the side and just use one swipe and as opposed to doing three of them, just because I didn't want to take away from the actual hairstyle. And although I like hers because she did have like a V-neck, and because it was Janet inspired, it made sense. For me, because I'm sitting here with a sweater on, it's a little much. You know, I want it to look as natural as possible. I don't want you to be like, oh, your wig is cute, but it's like, oh, you cut your hair, it's really nice, you know? And I don't do short hair often, but me and Tiana have a very similar face shape, so I was like, this would actually be, like, really cool to do something, like a celebrity-inspired look. And it was fun. It took me a while to do this because, like I told you guys, I haven't done a cut like this since beauty school, so I had to remember like all the laws of cutting because I'm so used to cutting my straight hair. But I will say that when I got to this side of my head, I had to make sure that I thinned it out because my hair was so full. And that's not a bad thing. That's a great thing because you guys know I've complained in the past a lot about wig companies giving you very thin wigs, and this was definitely a 150 density. It felt like it was very full, and although it was only 12 inches when I received it, I was like, I just don't want to do a middle part or a side part with this look. I want to do something that I could actually wear, and I've been actually wearing this. Like, I wear all my wigs, but this particular one is easy because the only thing I have to do is literally put it on and go about my day. I feel like one of my favorite movies, if y'all don't know, is Dennis the Menace, the live action version, and Dennis' hair was just like this. Like, it was so cute, and he had this really straight bang in the front that he would just do this with. So it easily turns into like a boy's haircut. You know, like I could get away with this. I might be a boy in makeup, but you know, what's new? But I like this because it's very like effortless. I made my eyebrows much thicker than I'm used to wearing them just because I wanted to do like the varsity situation. I like this a lot. It definitely reminds me of my James Dean look. And I want to say that Wig Encounters gets a 10 out of 10 for me because this wig gave me absolutely positively no issues. Like, none. Cutting was a breeze. Washing was no problem. Bleaching my knots was completely easy. I low-key, this is like Kris Jenner too, though. Mama Kris. If Kris Jenner was black, okay. But it was very easy to cut. The cap construction of it, which I should have shown, if not I'll show right now, of this wig is extremely, extremely nice. And it's a typical stretch cap. It's nothing like this different or, you know, edgy or new or whatever that you haven't seen before. It's pretty standard. I will say, I would like to work with Wig Encounters again because they definitely serve to make it more affordable. Their wigs are, from my understanding and the conversation that I had with them, is to provide good quality wigs at an affordable price for people who are beginners who do not want to break the bank to spend $1,700 on a damn lace wig. Like, I get it, especially because everything is ventilated and all this hair is hand plucked into the scalp. I totally understand that point. But at the same time, as you guys can tell, I like deep parts. That's another reason why I was drawn to her hairstyle as well, because y'all know I live for a good ignorant side part girl. I'm just here for it. So when I seen that, a lot of times when I buy wigs, you guys know I have my Toni Braxton wigs or whatever. I have, like, was on Sam's Beauty one day, and I seen a girl on YouTube and she did like an old school like mushroom look, and I found the wig and it was like $14, and I did it, and I brought like 8 other wigs to review, and I just never got around to those wigs. But the downside about them is because they're already cut, it's great, but you can't do this. You know what I'm saying? Like, you have this very limited space because they're not full wigs. They're like pretty much 27 pieces that are onto a cap. So the fact that they gave me the versatility to go ahead and have this full lace wig that I was able to actually glue down, and I used on just this section right here because I ran out of tape, my bold hold glue, but the rest of this right here that I use for my sideburn, I use bold hold tape. I don't have any more tape. I used like my last couple of pieces, but the tape is like the best thing ever because, again, I didn't want to do, because I wanted to do like this look or whatever and have the sideburn. It's very difficult to do this when you don't glue your unit down. Like, it's going to keep moving, it's going to keep shifting, so it's not going to lay down like you want to. But yeah, for all y'all who are asking, I will be doing a video on how I apply my boho glue and tape and removal, by the way. So again, I'm gonna go back and add some more texture back here just to make this part shorter, but I didn't want to make it too short because then I don't want to end up with something that I just didn't like, you know? So if you guys like this look, let me know. I mean, I like Tiana's was everything. I don't know the artist who did her hair, but whoever did her hair, you did the out of that, okay? Because it's amazing, and it definitely inspired me in this situation. Full throttle. I had to cut so many layers into this hair. It was ridiculous. Like, I was literally going every day, going back like, no, I gotta cut more, no, I gotta cut more, no, I gotta go more, just to try to make it as look and as close to hers as I could. So yeah, this was fun though, because it was a challenge for me because I hadn't did it in so long, but I definitely had a ball with this. So if you guys are interested, make sure you guys hit the link below. Again, this was a 12 inch that I went ahead and just cut into this nice, beautiful, I like to call it like a boy haircut, boy girl haircut, a very unisex haircut. And shout out to Wig Encounter, shout out to Bessie for being like the best patient person with me ever for allowing me to do this. And yeah, so if you guys are interested, hit the links below. And I'm not gonna even explain why I've been gone. It's just been great things happening, so don't worry, y'all know how I do. I'm in and out, I'm in and out. So I'll catch y'all on my next one. Peace.